So our top story tonight, President Trump's push for a wall on the border with Mexico has opened a diplomatic rift, and it raises the prospect of a major new tax. Lisa Desjardins begins our coverage.
The president of Mexico and myself have agreed to cancel our planned meeting scheduled for next week.
That was the president's version of events today. Hours earlier, Mexican President Enrique Pena Nieto canceled his scheduled visit to Washington. He'd come under heavy political pressure at home after Mr. Trump signed an executive order on Wednesday to start work on a border wall and insisted again that Mexico will ultimately pay for it. Today, the president gave no ground at the Congressional Republican retreat in Philadelphia.
Unless Mexico is going to treat the United States fairly, with respect, such a meeting would be fruitless, and I want to go a different route. We have no choice.
He also repeated calls to bolster deportation forces and eliminate refuges for the undocumented.
From day one, I've said it, and I mean the immediate removal of criminal aliens. They're going to be gone fast. And finally, at long last, cracking down on sanctuary cities.
Outside, protesters swarmed the area opposing the president's policies on immigration and other issues. But Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell said Congress is prepared to foot the bill for building the border wall, at least for now.
That issue, we are moving ahead, as the speaker pointed out to our group yesterday, with $12 to $15 billion. So we intend to address the wall issue ourselves. And the president can deal with his relations with other countries on that issue and other issues.
Later, en route back to Washington, White House spokesman Sean Spicer said the president wants a 20% tax on all imports from Mexico.
But by doing it that way, we can do $10 billion a year and easily pay for the wall just through that mechanism alone.
But a short time later, Spicer said that's just one option. At the same time, some Republicans, like Illinois Congressman Adam Kinzinger, say the country still needs a comprehensive immigration policy.
How do we fix our immigration system so that in 20, 30 years we're not back here again? And how do we deal with the folks that are here? You're not going to round up and deport 15 million people. You have to have some kind of a pathway to legalization.
There's unease with some of President Trump's other pronouncements as well. House Speaker Paul Ryan pushed back today against Mr. Trump's assertion to ABC News that torture works.
And torture's illegal. And torture's not legal. So, and we agree with it not being legal.
Mr. Trump did say he'd defer to his CIA director and incoming Secretary of Defense, both of whom have said they oppose a return to waterboarding in particular. Meanwhile, Mr. Trump returned to Washington this afternoon, ending his first day on Air Force One.
And Lisa joins us now. So, Lisa, what are the Republican members saying about this White House talk of an import tax on Mexican goods?
First of all, they're trying to get their hands around exactly what the president's proposing here. We hear from the House Speaker's office that they believe this is a reference to the plan House Republicans laid out last year. It's called the Border Adjustability Tax, and something I think we're going to talk a lot about in the coming months. But basically, it is a 20% tax, not just on Mexico, but basically on all imports into this country. It would change dramatically how this country deals with imports and exports and affect almost every business in this country. A very big deal. But Republicans now are trying to parse out whether the president is specifically proposing this, whether it's one idea. Exactly what Sean Spicer meant is still up in the air at this hour. But House Republicans are hoping that the president is full force behind this plan. They like it. Not everyone does. It's something that we're going to have to pay a lot of attention to.
Well, that is for sure. So, Lisa, as you look back on the 2 days of this conference, what was actually accomplished?
Yeah. Overall, Judy, the bottom line here is a timeline. The House Republicans have laid out, specifically the House, a 200-day agenda. What does that mean? That really means that by August, they want to have in their hands concrete proposals for how they will replace Obamacare and how they will repeal the tax code. Now, what does that mean? Does that mean they'll pass something by then? No one's exactly clear, but they want to have those proposals in hand by August. And Speaker Ryan today says they want everything passed by the end of the year. Those are ambitious goals. The timeline is what we have. We don't have the details of those plans. That's what they'll be doing for the next coming months.
And so, Lisa, what are members, one by one, what are they telling you in terms of whether they think that can happen?
There are some nervous members, because in addition to these very large plans, Obamacare and tax reform, they also have some things that have tripped up Republicans in the past, like the debt ceiling, which will come due shortly, and also another government spending bill. Those are things that Republicans have had trouble with in their own conference, and they take a lot of time. In addition, Judy, they do not have 60 votes in the Senate, and I spoke to several Republicans today who say, we need to be realistic about that. We can't push for everything we want and expect it, because we know that Senate Democrats are going to oppose us. We have to be sober, in the words of one Republican I talked to today.
Lisa Desjardins reporting from the Republican congressional retreat there in Philadelphia. Thank you. We'll hear from a senior White House advisor right after the news summary.